My name is Quinton. I need to get to Diamond City fast, but I don't know where I am. Raiders ambushed. They left me for dead. I was with three others, but the guards didn't make it. Cerina, she might be alive. My aunt, I have to go after her. We're coming down from the north, heading to Boston. They killed the rest of us, but they took her and all we had. We must look for a man named Pete. He might know where to find the raiders that did this to me. You got it. Talk right now.
Officer.
Sorry, but can't talk right now.
Watch your step. Got my eye on you.
Sorry, but can't talk right now.
I'm too friggin' slow to join the Minutemen.
Yes, what do you want? What are you doing in my office? I'm busy. Oh, Pete, you gotta help. Quinton, didn't I tell you that you don't work here anymore? Wait a minute, you look like shit. What the hell happened?
Raiders, my caravan was ambushed. They killed the guards and left me for dead, but they took Cerina. They were strong, really strong. We had no chance.
Raiders, eh? Were the three of them? One of them in a power armor?
Yeah. One of them a ghoul with a really big head.
Jeez. Okay, have a seat. Marcus Kalinowski goes by the name of Chief Beef from the Beef Crew. I've been trying to track him for years. He typically travels around with two of his henchmen, a woman and a ghoul. First, the infamous Maria Delamar, aka Porkchops, got banned from Good Neighbor for being a cannibal. Even for Good Neighbor, that's pretty wretched. Tyrone Benson, aka Crawdaddy, a highly skilled merc with some bad habits, got kicked out of the Gunners because of his excess chems addiction. He was proficient in the Gunners. That was until his wife left him because his head grew twice its normal size. Now he looks like a ghoul. He's been known to keep Mirelurks as pets. Got the nickname Crawdaddy. It's even been rumored that he had sexual intercourse with a Mirelurk queen. A real sicko, that one. That's enough to give feral ghouls nightmares. But enough about that. Look, I can point you to the place of Beef Town, but that's all I can do. I'll mark it on your map. The place is heavily guarded. So don't expect anybody to help you take them down. You're on your own. If you somehow manage to make it back here alive, I'll offer you a job. Let me know when you're done. I've gotta work.
Thank you.
think we should keep moving. I think we should keep moving. Thank you.
enough yammer already. What the hell was that?
Mine now!
Out of regular.
need to have my kids over here!
Turn up, you're dead.
Come on out. I'll make it nice and quick. You can trust me.
Scared, huh? You should.
I think we should keep moving.
Shit. Must have scared him off. fuck was that? What the hell was that?
There you are, you little bastard! Keep your eyes open! This asshole's using a stealth boy. No need to hide. It'll all be over soon. Show your face! Not even possible. Disappearing, Anton! Thought you could...
Well, well, well. Look what we've got here. Who the fuck do you think you are barging into my hideout and killing all my crew? You think you can just get away without there being any repercussions?
Let's kill him, boss.
The old lady from the caravan? She'll be meeting you in the afterlife as soon as we're done with you.
You were so dead.
Ah.
Oh, thanks heavens! I thought I was doomed for sure. Those raiders put me in the cell, and they were gonna kill me.
They were looking for some weapon. I'm not sure what it's supposed to do, but they killed my guards for it, then humiliated me. They kept asking me questions about who sold it to me. I told them I don't know. That's when they took all my things and put me in here. I overheard them fighting with each other, saying that the weapon they were looking for was incomplete. That's when the interrogation started. They kept asking me how I ended up in possession of it. I told them someone sold it to me. I don't know anything about it, but they wouldn't listen. Once we get out of here, I'll try to track down the seller. First, let's get my things and find a way out of here. I overheard the two henchmen complain about my alerts getting into the hideout. Apparently, Crawdaddy had been keeping them as pets for a very long time. If there's a way in, there might be a way out. Not our safest bet, but it's our only option.
Excuse me.
I think we should keep moving.
Thank you for getting me out of there. For everything you've done, you can keep that weapon and everything that was in the safe. I don't have much. It's all I can offer you. If you want to contact the seller of that weapon, I'll be in my cabin. I'm just so happy to be alive. Quinton and I will be heading back home. If you ever need anything, just drop by.
Well, as promised, here's your reward. Now, I'm not entirely sure if you want me to go with you or not. But it's your decision. I'm always up for traveling. Just ask me anytime. I'll be seeing you.